With NFL training camp being officially underway for all 32 teams, the NFL season and the NFL's fantasy season is quickly approaching. There are the top players everyone expects to do well, such as Saquon Barkley, Alvin Kamara, and DeAndre Hopkins. But there are also players who are flying under the radar and are considered sleepers. In this video, I will be discussing 5 players that I think are potential sleepers and should be targeted late in the draft. These players, in my opinion, all have low risk and high upside. Before I get started though, make sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel as all support is greatly appreciated. Now with that being said, let's begin. The first player that I think is underrated in terms of fantasy value for the 2019 season is Matthew Stafford of the Detroit Lions. Matt Bowen of ESPN currently has him projected 24th out of 30 quarterbacks, with players like Josh Allen, Sam Darnold, and Jameis Winston ranked above him. The only reason that I think Darnold would be ranked above Stafford is that Bowen thinks he's going to take a huge leap in year number 2. Just last year alone, Stafford threw for nearly 1,000 more yards, 4 more touchdowns, and threw 4 less interceptions, and in ESPN standard leagues had 212 fantasy points to Darnold's 168. I do not think Stafford will be a top 5 fantasy quarterback, but Stafford is usually good for a few 300-400 yard games per season. Last year alone, Stafford had 3 300 yard games and 8 multi-touchdown passing games. Stafford in 2019 also has Kenny Galladay a year older and first round pick TJ Hockenson to throw the pigskin to. While I do not think Stafford is a top 5 fantasy quarterback in 2019, he is being slept on and has considerable upside for where he is currently being valued. The next player that I think is currently being slept on is Jaguars running back Leonard Fournette. In non-PPR leagues on ESPN, he is currently ranked at 15th for the running back position, behind players like Nick Chubb, Dalvin Cook, and Sony Michel. No disrespect to Nick Chubb, but there's a running back by committee there with Kareem Hunt, or at least will be from week 9 on, which will severely limit his fantasy impact, and I think Fournette should be ranked above him personally. Dalvin Cook, and this pains me to say as a Vikings fan, but the injury concerns are very real, and I personally would not rank him above Fournette in a non-PPR league due to this. I like Dalvin and his potential a lot, but until we see him on the field for at least 12 games or more, that's all it is at this point, is potential. I'm a big Leonard Fournette supporter, and I think he and the Jaguars get back on track this year, or at least Fournette does, and he goes for his second 1,000-yard season in 3 years to start his career. I think Nick Foles will certainly help take some pressure off of him, as Blake Bortles doesn't exactly put intimidation into a defense the way a former Super Bowl MVP like Foles can. I look for Fournette to be a top 10 fantasy running back in standard leagues, which is definitely good value considering he is currently being ranked just inside the top 15. I think with the lack of team success for the Jaguars in 2018 combined with an injury-ridden year for Fournette, that has brought him in under the radar for the 2019 season. I think it will bring better production as to where he will be drafted for most fantasy owners. Moving on to the next sleeper, and that is Steelers wide receiver James Washington. James Washington is Matt Bowen's 49th ranked wide receiver in his non-PPR rankings, and I think that is entirely too low. We saw the impact Juju Smith-Schuster has had the past 2 seasons, and I think Washington can be a top 25 to 30 wide receiver. I could easily see Washington as the Steelers' number 2 option over Dante Moncrief over the course of the year. I think Washington has some of the highest upside in terms of fantasy based on where he is currently projected. I could absolutely see him having a 60 to 70 catch year with anywhere from 5 to 9 touchdowns, similar to what Juju did as a number 2 option in his rookie year to Antonio Brown. Moving on to the next underrated player, and that is Baltimore Ravens tight end Mark Andrews. As a rookie, Andrews impressively averaged over 16 yards per catch and had 2 catches go for over 70 yards. Admittedly, I am not a Hayden Hurst fan and think he will be a complete bust when his career is all said and done. That's not to say Andrews will make up for what Hurst should have been as a first-round draft pick. Second-year quarterback Lamar Jackson really liked going to Andrews down the stretch last season after he took over the offense for veteran quarterback Joe Flacco, and I think their chemistry only grows in year 2. I think Andrews, given the fact he had over 550 yards receiving as a rookie tight end, can explode onto the NFL scene and go for 800 yards and 8 touchdowns as a sophomore. Andrews' 550 yards receiving is extremely impressive for a tight end, as All-Pro Zach Ertz only had 469 as a rookie, and George Kittle had 515 as a rookie. I really like the upside from Andrews and think he will be a top 10 fantasy tight end at the end of 2019. The final sleeper in this video is a player I like a lot and have liked a lot since he came out of Southern Methodist University, and that is Broncos second-year wide receiver Courtland Sutton. In his rookie season, Sutton went for over 700 yards receiving on just 42 catches and had 4 touchdowns as well. It is no secret that Joe Flacco likes his big body targets, dating back to the Super Bowl run in 2012 when he liked throwing to Anquan Boldin and Dennis Pitta. I think Sutton is in for a huge year, whether it's Flacco or rookie quarterback Drew Lock throwing him the football. I am predicting that Sutton will go for over 1,000 yards and have at least 6 touchdowns. I think Sutton's final stat line will look something like 60 catches, 1,050 yards, and 7 touchdowns, which will be a huge step in the right direction for the second-year player. If Locke comes in sooner rather than later for Flacco, I think that will only help Courtland's future in 2020 and beyond, as Locke to Sutton could very well be a lethal combo in the Mile High City for the next 6 to 8 years. That's all I have for today's video. I hope you enjoyed watching, and if you did, please subscribe to the channel and like the video, as I will be posting weekly videos talking about potential sleepers, good performances, or just talking about football in general. Again, thank you for watching, and have a great day.